Have you ever been under the assumption that the world is out to get you? Have you ever felt like a victim of the circumstances that surround you? Have you ever felt like some people around you should just be on your side? I'm Adam from Thoughts in Motion, and today I'm going to change your perspective of people and the world around you. So to start this video, I'm gonna give you two varying situations, okay? Ones that I've been in personally, okay? So with working in the restaurant industry that I do, I've come across a lot of douchebags and I've come across a lot of nice people. Now, one table in particular that I served, she was very aggressive towards us. It was a very, how can I say this, simple situation that she escalated beyond belief, okay? So what happened was, she came in earlier for a drink and we still had the drink on the system that hadn't been paid for, right? Or at least we assumed that it hadn't been paid for, right? So there was varying rumors that yes, they paid, no, they hadn't. And so we needed to know. So they came back later on and we kindly said to her, like, oh, do you have a receipt for this? Like, we've had a system problem. Like, we just want to make sure that we can cash it off with the receipt, right? And instantly she assumed that we were accusing her of robbing the store, that this is theft, you should be sacked, blah, 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 blah. All this aggressive shit for something that was very simple and could easily be solved, right? And we were like, whoa, like, what's going on? And she was very victimized. She felt victimized. She felt like we were against her, like, we should be sacked. She's gonna ring the police and all this shit, right? Which, of course, no one ever does. It's just an over-exaggeration, right? Compare this to another customer that I served. Him and his family received all their food cold, some of it burnt. And usually you would expect in that situation for someone to absolutely fly off the handle, to be really upset, okay? And this guy said, yo, I see you guys are busy. I don't mind. If you just replace all the food, it'll be sound. And he was the calmest fucking guy I'd ever seen in my life. And we admired him. Me and the manager were like, holy shit, this guy is on another level compared to the most people we serve. And it was really genuine. It was authentic. And he even tipped us at the end, which is great. So compare those two stories. What changed, right? What's the difference between the two? The two is their perspective of other people. And that's what I want to talk about in this video, changing your perspective of other people and trying to understand things from their perspective. So for example, in that busy restaurant where all the food was shit, like, he could have looked at us and said, you know what, yous are shit, yous are not professional, your food sucks, blah, 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 all this sort of shit, and got really aggressive and angry. But he decided to take a step back and see it from our perspective and look around at the restaurant and say, you know what, this is busy as fuck. Let's give these people the benefit of the doubt, right? Because this is a one-time experience, it's a one-time thing, shit happens, right? Compare that with the first story, for example, where instantly on the defensive, instantly on the negative, instantly flashing into aggression, right? Some people are like that in the world. Yes, you'll come across these people, you'll come across these people all the time, and you've just got to deal with it, right? But for you personally, it is up to you how you decide to answer to these situations. The energy which you choose to put out in the world will determine the perspective that you see everyone and everything around you. So for example, I try to focus on as much empathy as I can. This is what we might call high vibration energy versus low vibration energy. So it's a very spiritual concept and I'm not 100% convinced by it, but in the same way that you can't hear a dog whistle doesn't mean it doesn't exist. When you put out negativity, when you put out this horrible aggression, when you expect the worst, when you treat people with, you know, this ego, this strange authority, and you see them as, you know, service or help or, you know, pieces of shit rather than as the people that they are, that's when you start to delve deep into the low vibration energy. So in order to get high vibration, it comes with things like empathy, sympathy, things like taking a step back. It's not all about you, looking at it from the perspective of the other person. And this will really change your perspective and probably give you a lot more opportunities in life when it comes to success and happiness. Because when you start coming from a collaborative frame of mind rather than a competitive frame of mind, that's when things really open up to you. So for example, a collaborative frame of mind is seeing that how can I help people and how can, you know, how can we benefit each other? Whereas a competitive frame of mind is, oh, I'm gonna beat this guy, no one can be better than me. How dare they do this? A victim complex rather than a one of raising other people up with you. So to round off this video, guys, I just wanna say don't be a douchebag. See things from other people's perspective. See the positive outcome in things. Be collaborative, not competitive. Don't see everyone as a scammer or someone that's against you, and stop seeing yourself as such a victim of these circumstances. Remember the woman that accused us of, like, accusing her of stealing, right? Why jump off the handle like that? Why not go, oh, you know what? Maybe it was a mistake. Oh, here's my receipt. Done. Like, don't make things out to be a bigger drama than they are. Keep things simple, but never simpler than they are. For example, if someone is being a dick to you, rather than being, oh, let's collaborate, right? No, if they're being a dick to you, you need to put your boundaries down and say, this is not something that I'm gonna live with, right? But at the same time, if things don't need to be exaggerated, then they don't need to be exaggerated. Keep it simple, keep it happy, and keep it collaborative. That's it for this video, guys. Be sure to like, subscribe, and click the bell to get all the notifications whenever we post new content. I've been Adam from Thoughts in Motion. See you in the next video.